Okay. My voice is audible? My voice is audible or not? Okay. In this metallurgy chapter, now we are discussing metallurgy chapter. In this metallurgy chapter, already we have discussed the general principles of metallurgy and also one metal extraction. That means extraction of copper. Already we have discussed. And now today we are discussing about the extraction of iron. Extraction of iron. Let us see. Extraction of iron. Let us see how we can extract iron. If we extract iron, what is the first step? Which metal, which substance we have to collect first? Tell me, anyone. If we extract iron, iron metal, what is the first step? What is the first step?
Ore, sir.
To collect the ore. To collect the ore. First, we have to choose a ore of iron. See, iron is occur in different ores, iron occurrence. Iron is the second most abundant metal after aluminium. In earth crust, first most abundant metal is aluminium. That means ekkuva earth crust lo ekkuva dorike metal enti ante aluminium. Second most abundant metal enti ante iron. But elemental paranga vachinam anko, in terms of elements paranga iskunte, fourth most abundant element in earth crust. Iron is the second most abundant metal in earth crust and fourth most abundant element in earth crust. It is mostly occurs in combined state only. It doesn't occur in free state. That means iron is directly in free state. Is not occur. Only it occurs in combined state only. Combined state only. Let us see what are the ores of iron. What are the ores of iron? See. Here several ores are given. Hematite, magnetite, limonite, siderite, iron pyrites, copper pyrites. These all ores are iron ores. Hematite, magnetite, limonite, siderite, iron pyrites, copper pyrites. These are all the iron ores. So let us see what is the composition of hematite. Hematite composition, hematite formula is Fe2O3. Fe2O3 is the oxide ore. Oxide ores. Fe2O3 is oxide ore. Hematite is oxide ore. Next, magnetite. The formula of the magnetite is Fe3O4. Fe3O4. Fe3O4 is the magnetite O. Fe3O4. Magnetite. Fe3O4. Magnetite. Next, limonite. Limonite is 2Fe2O3, 3H2O. Formula of limonite, 2Fe2O3, 3H2O. This is the hydrated oxide. Hydrated oxide means here water molecules are there. Hydrated oxide. Next, siderite. The formula of siderite is FeCO3. This is the carbonate ore. Iron pyrites. FeS2 is known as iron pyrites. Copper pyrites, CuFeS2. These are all the iron ores. If we want to extract iron metal from earth crust, first we have to collect this iron ores. Any one of the iron ore. Say yes or no. Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Next, principles of extraction of iron. Principles of extraction of iron. Let us see how we will extract iron. We have three types of iron. One is cast iron, rough iron, steel. Cast iron, rough iron, steel. We have three types of iron. Several types of iron is there. But here we are discussing only three types of irons. One is cast iron. Second one is rough iron. Third one is steel. all are irons, but these irons are mixed with some other element. Let us see. Cast iron. What is mean by cast iron? Cast iron means iron plus 4% carbon is known as cast iron. Iron plus 4% carbon mixture is known as cast iron. Rough iron means iron plus 0.2% carbon. Rough iron means iron plus 0.2% carbon is known as rough iron. Steel, iron plus 0.5 to 1.5% carbon is known as steel. Here, these compositions are very important in objective way. In objective questions, here the question was asked in the way of the cast iron. In cast iron, what is the percentage of carbon? 4%. In rough iron, what is the percentage of carbon? 0.2%. In steel, what is the carbon percentage? 0.5 to 1.5%. Like that, questions will be asked. Today, we will discuss about how to extract these irons, cast iron, rough iron, steel, how to prepare this cast iron, rough iron, steel. Most important, vachesi, cast iron is the most important. This is the most, cast iron nunche rough iron steel prepare chestam. Cast iron nunche rough iron steel prepare chestam. Understand or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, first one, manufacture of cast iron. Manufacture of cast iron. Iron is extracted from its oxides in blast furnace. Blast furnace. Iron is extracted from its oxides in blast furnace. This is the blast furnace. Iron is prepared from its oxides. What is the iron oxide ores? Tell me one name of the iron oxide.
Hematite or magnetite.
Hematite is a oxide ore. Magnetite is also oxide ore. We can extract the iron from these oxide ore in a blast furnace. What is meant by furnace? What is furnace? Tell me. What is furnace? Furnace is a heating substance. Sorry, heating operator. This is the blast furnace. This instrument is known as blast furnace. This instrument produce heat. See, this is an almost cylindrical furnace lined inside with fire bricks. Here, this blast furnace is cylindrical shape, and this cylindrical furnace, this blast furnace lined with these walls are lined with fire bricks. It is charged. It is charged from the top with an iron ore, 8 parts. Desulfurized coke 4 parts and limestone 1 part and is mixed in 8:4:1 parts by weight. Here it is charged from the top. That means any substance we are adding from the top of this blast furnace. We can add any substance into this blast furnace from top of this blast furnace. In this blast furnace, we are adding the substance iron core, desulfurized coke, and limestone in the ratio of 8:4:1 parts by weight. Iron ore means Fe2O3. For example, hematite, 8 parts, and desulfurized coke. Desulfurized coke means carbon without sulfur. Desulfurized coke, 4 parts. Limestone means CaCO3, calcium carbonate. 1 part mixed in 8:4:1 parts by weight. Air, see this image. Air is blown from the bottom. The components which we are adding to this in this blast furnace is added from top side. air is blown from the bottom. Here, two inlet pipes are there. Inlet pipes are there. From these pipes, air will be sent. Air will be sent. Air is blown from the bottom. The coke buns producing heat and CO. Here, in this blast furnace, coke buns, we are adding desulfurized coke. Coke buns producing heat and carbon monoxide. Coke buns producing heat and carbon monoxide. The temperature range in the furnace is 300 degrees C to 1600 degrees C. The temperature range in this blast furnace is 300 degrees C to 1600 degrees C. There is a lot of difference between, lot of difference in the range of temperature range. Yes or no? 300 to 1600 degrees C temperature range is there in this blast furnace.
Yes, sir.
Various reactions takes place in the blast furnace at different temperatures and different zones. 300 to 1600 degrees C means there is a lot of difference between 300 degrees C and 1600 degrees C. Between 300 to 1600 degrees C, different temperature zones are there, and at different temperature zones, different reactions will take place. At different temperature zones, different reactions will take place. Let us see what are the reactions takes place at different temperature range and different zones. First, you understand or not? Iron is iron is in several types of irons are there. Here we are discussing about cast iron, rough iron and steel. Cast iron means iron plus carbon, carbon 4%. Rough iron means iron plus 0.2% carbon. Steel means iron plus 0.5 to 1.5% carbon. Now we are discussing about the manufacture of cast iron. Manufacture of cast iron. Iron is extracted from its oxide ores in blast furnace. This is a blast furnace. This blast furnace is almost in cylindrical shape. This cylindrical shape blast furnace is lined with fire bricks. And to this blast furnace, we are adding the substance iron oxide, that means iron ore, and desulfurized coke and limestone from the top of this this blast furnace in the ratio of 8:4:1, 8:4:1 ratio. Air is blown from the bottom inlets. Bottom inlet pipes are there. Through these inlet pipes, we will send the air into this blast furnace. Air is blown from the bottom. The coke buns producing heat and carbon monoxide. Here, coke is there. These coke buns and heat will produce and carbon monoxide will produce. The temperature range in this furnace is 300 to 1600 degrees C. A lot of difference is there in temperature range. Various reactions take place in the blast furnace at different temperature and different zones. Let us see what happens in the temperature range 300 to 1600 degrees in this blast furnace. See. Temperature range, name of zone, changes occur in zone, chemical reaction. Let us see, between 400 to 700 degrees C, what will happen? Between 400 to 700 degrees C, what will happen? Between 400 to 700 degrees C, zone of reduction, between 400 to 700 degrees C. Actually, this blast furnace temperature range is 300 to 1600 degrees C. Between 400 to 700 degrees C, the name of the zone is zone of reduction. What will happen in 400 degrees C to 700 degrees C means reduction will take place. Reduction will take place. See, change is occurring in this zone between 400 to 700 degrees C. After adding the substances into this blast furnace, between 400 to 700 degrees C, spongy iron is formed in iron oxide. Spongy iron is formed. Iron oxide is reduced. See, iron oxide, Fe2O3. What is Fe2O3? Tell me. What is Fe2O3?
Hematite.
Hematite. Fe2O3 reacts with the carbon. Carbon means coke. We are adding the substance iron oxide and desulfurized coke and calcium carbonate. Iron oxide reacts with coke. Then this Fe2O3 is reduced to Fe. and also carbon monoxide will form. Fe2O3, the oxidation state of iron is what? Tell me anybody. Fe2O3, in Fe2O3, iron oxidation state is what? What is the oxidation state of iron?
-3.
No, +3. 2x minus 6 is equal to 0.
Yes, 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 +3, sir.
In iron, this what is the oxidation state of this iron?
0, sir.
0. Why? Because it is an elemental state iron. If plus iron plus 3 to iron 0 will come, that reaction is oxidation or reduction? That process.
Reduction process.
Gain of electrons. Iron plus 3 receives 3 electrons and form iron 0. And also, Fe2O3 reacts with carbon monoxide. Here, carbon monoxide also release. Carbon monoxide will form. This Fe2O3 again reacts with carbon monoxide and forms iron and carbon dioxide. Here also Fe2O3. In Fe2O3, iron is plus 3. Here, elemental iron is there. Here also Fe0. Here also reduction will take place. Simply, between 400 to 700 degrees C, reduction will take place. Reduction will take place from iron oxide. Iron oxide undergo reduction with coke. We will get spongy iron. Only iron will get. We will get iron. That iron is known as spongy iron. Next, between 800 to 1000 degrees C, what will happen? Let us see. Between 800 to 1000 degrees C, it is a zone of slag formation. Slag will form. What is meant by slag?
Flux and gangs.
Flux and if we combine flux with the gang is combined with the flux, we will get a easily fusible product. That product is known as a slag. Let us see here. Carbon dioxide is reduced to CO. This between 800 degrees C to 1000 degrees C, what will happen? Carbon dioxide is reduced to CO. Limestone decomposes to lime and CO2. Lime combines with SiO2 to form the slag CaSiO3. Let us see. Here, carbon dioxide will form. In the first step, 400 to 700 degrees C, carbon dioxide is formed. This carbon dioxide is reduced with carbon. We will get carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide. See, in carbon dioxide, what is the oxidation state of carbon?
+4, sir.
+4. What is the oxidation state of carbon in carbon monoxide? Simple.
+2.
+2. +4 to +2 will come, it is a oxidation or reduction?
Reduction.
Reduction. Carbon dioxide undergo reduced and form carbon monoxide. Next, calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate decomposes into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Next, this calcium oxide reacts with SiO2. We will get CaSiO3. Here, what is meant by calcium carbonate? Here, what is calcium carbonate? Calcium carbonate is outside adding substance. Is it correct or not? We are adding external substance. Calcium carbonate is external substance or not?
Yes, sir. Flux.
Yes, sir.
So, calcium carbonate acts as a flux. Next, here we are, which O we are taking? Tell me. Which O we are taking? We extract the iron, which O we are taking? Tell me.
Hematite.
The formula of hematite is?
Fe2O3.
This Fe2O3 is collected from where?
Oxide ore, sir.
Yes, oxide ore. That ore is taken from where?
Mineral, sir.
Okay, mineral is collected from where?
Earth crust.
This earth, in earth crust, along with the, if we collect the iron oxide, that means hematite ore, along with the hematite ore, some of impurities are there. Earth crust lo sand untada?
Yes, sir.
SiO2. SiO2 means silica. Silica and sand. This calcium carbonate is the flux. This calcium carbonate decomposes CaO plus CO2. This CaO is reacts with the gang particles. CaSiO2 is the gang particles. SiO2 is the impurity or not in Fe2O3?
Yes, sir.
SiO2 is the silica. Silica is the sand particles. This silica is silica. What is the technical word for impurity?
Gang.
This CaO comes from outside of substance, flux. Flux reacts with gang. We will get CaSiO3. Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
This is the calcium silicate. If flux reacts with gang particles, we will get CaSiO3. This CaSiO3 is known as slag. Wait 1 minute. Okay. Second step, between 800 degrees C to 1000 degrees C, what will happen? Are you understand or not? Are you understand or not? Tell me in the first two steps, what will happen? You understand or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. At 1200 degrees C to 1300 degrees C, what will happen? Let us see. At 1200 to 1300 degrees C, it is a zone of fusion. Coke burns to CO2 and iron melts. Any iron oxide remaining? Wait. Okay, see, between 1200 to 1300 degrees C, coke burns to CO2 and iron melts. Iron oxide remaining is completely reduced to iron. Here, we are adding some coke. That coke is reduced to carbon dioxide. Sorry, coke burns to CO2, coke reacts with oxygen and CO2 will form and iron melts. Any iron oxide remaining is completely reduced to iron. Still, any iron oxide is there. That iron oxide is completely reduced to iron in the temperature range of 1200 to 1300 degrees C. And next, above 1400 degrees C, let us see what will happen. Above 1400 degrees C, molten iron collects in the bottom of the hearth. Above 1400 degrees C, molten iron collects in the bottom of the hearth. This is the bottom of the hearth. Blast furnace undi kada, bottom nunchi molten iron collects chestha. Molten iron means, what is mean by molten iron?
Liquid iron.
This molten iron is known as pig iron. Name of this molten iron is pig iron. Molten iron is pig iron. See, the iron obtained is known as pig iron. This pig iron is in liquid state or solid state?
Tell me. Liquid.
Liquid state. If we cool the liquid state iron, that means molten state iron, we will get a solid iron. That solid iron is known as cast iron. This cast iron contains iron and 4% of carbon. Have you understand or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The next important. What is mean by pig iron? molten iron is molten iron, molten state iron is pig iron. This molten state iron is by cooling the pig iron, we will get solid iron. That solid iron is known as cast iron. In that cast iron, we are having 4% carbon along with iron. Next, we have discussed about cast iron. Cast iron means iron plus 4% of carbon. Now we are extracting or manufacturing rough iron and steel. Here we will manufacture rough iron and steel from cast iron. Okay, by using cast iron we will manufacture rough iron and steel. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Manufacture of rough iron. See, rough iron is the purest form of iron, containing only 0.2% carbon. Rough iron means iron plus 0.2% carbon. This is the purest form of iron. It is prepared by heating cast iron in a reverberatory furnace. This is the reverberatory furnace. Just design will change. All our furnaces. Furnaces is used for heating purpose. It is prepared by heating cast iron in a reverberatory furnace. The furnace is given a basic lining of iron oxide. This furnace is lining with iron oxide. That means inside of the walls are lined with are coated with iron oxide. Inside walls are coated with iron oxide. See, the impurities and the carbon present in cast iron. What is present in cast iron? What is the composition of cast iron? Tell me. What is the mixture of cast iron? What is cast iron? Iron plus carbon. Carbon 4%. In cast iron, if there are impurities and carbon is there, we will to manufacture rough iron. That 4% carbon is reduced to 0.2% carbon. Is it correct or not? 4% or 4% carbon is decreased to 0. We have to decrease carbon from 4% to 0.2%. See, the impurities and the carbon present in cast iron combines with the lining. What is meant by lining? Lining means this reverberatory furnace inside walls are coated with Fe2O3. That is lining. The impurities from slag and carbon is oxidized to CO and escapes. The impurities and the carbon present in cast iron combines with the lining. The impurities from the slag and the carbon is oxidized to CO and escapes. See, the impurities and carbon present in cast iron combines with the lining. Evaina impurities unna, carbon unna, cast iron. The impurities and carbon present in cast iron lo unde impurities and carbon ee lining tho combine ayipoyi, the impurities form a slag. Ikkada impurities Fe2O3 తో ఈ కోట్ చేసినాం కదా Fe2O3 తో దాంతో కంబైన్ అయిపోయి స్లాగ్ ని ఫామ్ చేస్తుంది అండ్ కార్బన్ వచ్చేసి ఆక్సిడైజ్డ్ టు CO అండ్ ఎస్కేప్స్ ఇట్ బర్న్స్ విత్ ఏ బ్లూ ఫ్లేమ్ ద ఫ్లేమ్స్ ఆర్ నోన్ యాజ్ పర్డలర్స్ క్యాండిల్స్ ఇది బ్లూ ఫ్లేమ్ తో బర్న్ అవుతుంది ఈ దీన్ని ఏమంటాం అంటే పుడ్లర్స్ క్యాండిల్స్ అంటాం హెన్స్ ద ప్రాసెస్ ఇస్ నోన్ యాజ్ పుడ్లింగ్ ప్రాసెస్ లెట్ us see. Carbon and various impurities present combine with the lining and form slag. Lining is prepared. Lining means this reverberatory furnace inside walls are coated with Fe2O3. Then carbon and various impurities combine with the lining and form slag. See here what will happens. Carbon, this carbon comes from where? Here 3C. this carbon is comes from where?
Cast iron.
In cast iron, iron plus 4% carbon is there. That carbon reacts with Fe2O3. Where is this Fe2O3? Where? Where is this Fe2O3? Tell me.
Lining, sir.
Lining. Yes, very nice. This inside walls are coated with Fe2O3. Reverberatory furnace inside walls are coated with Fe2O3. This carbon reacts with this Fe2O3. We will get iron and carbon monoxide. We will get iron and carbon monoxide. And next. Next, see, manganese still in that cast iron, any impurities are there. For example, manganese is there. This manganese reacts with Fe2O3, we will get iron and manganese oxide. And also silica, if silica is there, silica also reacts with Fe2O3, we will get iron and 3 SiO2. Next, manganese oxide reacts with SiO2, we will get MnSiO3. This is the slag. Here, finally, we are getting iron plus 0.2% carbon only in this rough iron. This is the rough iron. In this way, we will get iron. In this process, we are getting iron plus 0.2% carbon. This is the way to manufacture rough iron. Okay, let us see next. Manufacture of steel. This is the Bessemer converter. This is the Bessemer converter. Steel contains iron plus 0.5 to 1.5% carbon. Steel is the iron plus 0.5 to 1% carbon. It is prepared by following air through molten pig iron. It is prepared by blowing air through molten pig iron taken in a Bessemer converter. This Bessemer converter also used for heating purpose and heating purpose. Steel contains iron 0.5 to 1.5% carbon. It is prepared by blowing air through molten pig iron in this Bessemer converter. Molten iron is there. Molten iron means, what is mean by molten iron? Molten iron means pig iron taken in this Bessemer converter. The process is, let us see, what is the process in occur in Bessemer converter? The Bessemer converter is a pear-shaped furnace. This is the pear-shaped furnace. It construct with steel. This Bessemer converter is constructed with steel. It is lined with silica or lime, depending upon the proportions of the impurities present in the iron. This Bessemer converter is prepared with this Bessemer converter is lined or coated with silica or lime. Air is forced through the inlet of the bottom. Here one inlet is there, inlet pipe is there. Through this inlet we will send the air into this Bessemer converter. Next, carbon and various other impurities present combined with oxygen and form slag. Carbon and various other impurities present combines with oxygen. Carbon already in pig iron, carbon is there, and various other impurities is there present combined with oxygen. Here we are sending air first in this Bessemer converter. We will take molten iron, that means liquid state iron. In this liquid state iron, some impurities are there, and iron and 4% carbon is there. While we are sending air, this air reacts with this carbon and various other impurities. We will get a slag. Let us see what are the reactions occur in this Bessemer converter. First, Fe3C. Fe3C is the pig iron. The composition of pig iron is Fe3C. Reacts with oxygen, we will get iron plus carbon monoxide. And silica reacts with SiO2. Silica is the impurity. And manganese is also impurity. Manganese reacts with oxygen, we will get manganese oxide. Iron reacts with oxygen, we will get iron oxide. P4 reacts with 5 moles of oxygen, we will get P4O10. MnO reacts with SiO2. This MnO reacts with SiO2. This SiO2 reacts with, we will get MnSiO3. This is the slag. And also, FeO also reacts with SiO2. Here, FeO will form and SiO2. FeO reacts with SiO2, we will get FeSiO3. And calcium oxide. Calcium oxide also, it's impurity. Calcium oxide reacts with P4O10. We will get Ca3PO4 taken twice. This is also slag. These are the reactions occur in this Bessemer conductor. Main reaction is this. This one is the main reaction. In this way, we will prepare steel. Okay. Here, in every reaction, oxygen to react. Oxygen ekkadi nunchi vastundi? Chappandi.
Manam kinda chestu unnam sir.
Air pass chestunnam kada, deeni nunchi manam inlet dwara ఆక్సిజన్ ఇస్తాను. ఇవ సిలిక ఇక్కడ Fe3C ఎక్కడ ఉంది? Fe3C ఎక్కడి నుంచి వచ్చింది? Fe3C అంటే పిగ్ ఐరన్. మనం యాడ్ చేస్తున్నాం, మనం యాడ్ చేస్తాం మోల్టన్ ఐరన్ మనం యాడ్ చేస్తాం. అండ్ సిలికా ఎస్ఐ ఎట్లా వచ్చింది? పిగ్ ఐరన్లో ఉండే ఇంప్యూరిటీ. మ్యాంగనీస్ కూడా ఇంప్యూరిటీనే. నెక్స్ట్ ఐరన్ దాంట్లోనే ఉంటుంది. నెక్స్ట్ P4 ఇంప్యూరిటీ. MnO ఇక్కడ ఫామ్ అయింది. FeO ఇక్కడ ఫామ్ అయింది. CaO ఇక్కడ ఫామ్ అయింది. CaO లేదు, CaO కూడా ఇంప్యూరిటీనే. ఇవి CaO ఆల్సో ఇంప్యూరిటీ. ఫస్ట్ ఇన్ స్టార్టింగ్ కాల్షియం కార్బోనేట్ మనం యూజ్ చేసినాం కదా, స్టార్టింగ్ లో ఇక్కడ కాల్షియం కార్బోనేట్ యాడ్ చేస్తున్నాం కదా, దాంట్లో CaO ఉంటుంది కదా, అది CaO. ఓకే, అర్థమైందా లేదా ఇది? సార్ ప్రాక్టీస్ చేస్తే గుర్తుంటది. నెక్స్ట్ యూజెస్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్. లెట్ అస్ సీ ద యూజ్. వాట్ ఆర్ ద యూజెస్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్? ఇట్ ఈస్ యూజ్డ్ ఇన్ ద మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ ఆఫ్ రఫ్ ఐరన్ అండ్ స్టీల్. క్యాస్ట్ ఐరన్ ఈస్ యూజ్డ్ ఇన్ ద మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ ఆఫ్ రఫ్ ఐరన్ అండ్ స్టీల్. క్యాస్ట్ ఐరన్ ఈస్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ క్యాస్టింగ్ స్టవ్స్, రైల్వే స్లీపర్స్, టాయ్స్ ఎట్సెట్రా. రైల్వే స్టేషన్ లో సారీ రైల్వే స్లీపింగ్ స్లీపర్ కోచెస్ లో బెడ్స్ ఉంటాయి కదా, ఆ ఐరన్ తో తయారు చేసి ఉంటారు కదా, ఆ బెడ్స్ ఈ క్యాస్ట్ ఐరన్ తో యూజ్ చేస్తారు, ప్రిపేర్ చేస్తారు. నెక్స్ట్ రఫ్ ఐరన్ ఇస్ యూజ్డ్ మేకింగ్ వైర్స్, బోల్ట్స్, యాంకర్స్, చైన్స్ అండ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్. నెక్స్ట్ నికెల్ స్టీల్. నికెల్ స్టీల్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ మేకింగ్ కేబుల్స్, ఆటోమొబైల్స్ అండ్ ఏరోప్లేన్ పార్ట్స్, పెండులమ్, మెజరింగ్ టేప్స్. క్రోమ్ స్టీల్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ కటింగ్ టూల్స్ అండ్ క్రషింగ్ మిషన్స్. నెక్స్ట్ స్టెయిన్లెస్ స్టీల్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ సైకిల్స్, ఆటోమొబైల్, యుటెన్సిల్స్, పెన్స్. స్టెయిన్లెస్ స్టీల్ మీన్స్ కార్బన్ కాంపోజిషన్ డిఫరెంట్ ఉంటుంది. స్టెయిన్లెస్ స్టీల్ లో కూడా ఐరన్, కార్బన్ ఉంటుంది. క్రోమ్ స్టీల్ అంటే ఐరన్ ప్లస్ క్రోమియం, నికెల్ స్టీల్ అంటే ఐరన్ ప్లస్ నికెల్. దీస్ ఆర్ ద డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్స్. దీస్ ఆర్ ద యూజెస్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్. దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఎక్స్ట్రాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్ అండ్ యూజెస్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్. సెవరల్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్ ఆర్ దేర్, బట్ వీఆర్ డిస్కస్డ్ ఓన్లీ 3 టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్. వన్ ఈస్ క్యాస్ట్ ఐరన్, రఫ్ ఐరన్, స్టీల్. Have you understand or not?
Stainless steel ayunda sir, iron plus
carbon.
Okay sir, okay sir,
okay. Nenu meer ee rendu class lo gamanichinaru, ee rendu class lo complete english lo cheptam unda, english lo cheppamantara complete ga telugu mix cheyamantara? Okay, first I will stop the recording. I will talk with you. Don't left.